What's up, guys? Jay? We're Nanthrakill, and I'm back with some more Borderlands 3 pre-release coverage. And you know, ever since Borderlands 2 killed off Handsome Jack, and Tales from the Borderlands made damn sure that even his digital consciousness can't ever return, one of the biggest questions that the Borderlands fan base has had is, who will the next game's antagonist be? Will it be Patricia Tanis, foreshadowed by the Battleborn Easter egg? Or will it be the Iridian Guardians? Maybe even Lilith. It could have gone either way after the pre-sequel story, but that question was answered with the Borderlands 3 reveal trailer to be absolutely none of the above. So, who is the antagonist of Borderlands 3? And how do you top Handsome Jack, one of the best villains in a video game since Sephiroth in Final Fantasy VII? And it seems that Gearbox's answer to that is to make two antagonists, the Calypso twins, Troy and Tyreen, respectively. Now, we know they're evil because Randy Pitchford actually kind of said it in the conference, but we also know they're evil from the trailer because of the upside down vote symbol imagery painted over their heads on the signs. It's sort of how like the satanic followers use the upside down cross as their idolic symbol. Yeah, yeah. Kind of see the comparison there. But it seems that out of the two Calypso twins, that Troy is the higher up calling all the shots, even going so far as to calling himself the father of the children of the Vault, which is, you know, their following. It's a group of cultists obsessed with finding the various Vaults spread across the universe. Now, how they plan on doing this is purely up to speculation, but judging from the trailer, it looks like there's a scene where the Calypso twins meet up with Lilith and there's a Vault key involved, and Tyreen seems to have stripped Lilith of her siren powers, indicated by her crawling on the ground without any of her tattoos on her arm. And you can see in the background that she's now given these powers to Troy. So it seems like their plan hinges on stripping all the sirens of their powers and superpowering Troy as the one true father of the Vault. So it stands to seem that Tyreen, who is a natural born siren, you can see the blue tattoos on her arm, it seems like her ability is the ability to strip other sirens of their abilities. Sort of like Leech from the X-Men. If you saw X-Men Last Stand, he was the kid who was in Alcatraz and his power was to strip any of the power of mutants nearby him. But another thing to note is that when Tyreen gives Troy Lilith's powers, his tattoos on his arm become red instead of blue. And we've actually seen this before in the Borderlands franchise. Believe it or not, when Handsome Jack captured Lilith, her eyes and the background of her head was glowing red. So it seems in the Borderlands universe, when sirens' powers are being used against their will, that they're indicated by a red glow instead of blue. Now, one of the most interesting things about the trailer that I haven't seen anyone talking about yet is the scene where Lilith loses her powers. Troy only has one crystal glowing around his neck. And later on, you can see him with two glowing crystals around his neck and more red tattoos around his eyes. So I wouldn't be surprised if Lilith loses her powers early on in the game and we see him absorb more than just one siren powers along the way, seeing him becoming super ultra powered. But it's looking like that the siren powers have to be contained in some sort of crystal around his neck for him to be able to use those powers. So I don't know if that's exactly how it works, but that's what I'm thinking the way it's looking in these trailers. So, my name is Jay, more than Afterkill. I want to thank you guys for watching. Make sure you guys rate, comment, subscribe. If you leave some of the video, I'd highly appreciate it because it gives me motivation to make more videos for y'all motherfuckers. Watch my motherfucking videos. But let me know in the comment section down below, do you like where they're going with the story in the Borderlands franchise? Because personally, you know, I'm excited to see them expand and explore the lore behind the Volts, the Guardians, the Sirens, and what their overall connection is to the Volt. But I want to know what you think in the comment section down below. My name's Jay, more than Afterkill. Thanks for watching. I'm going to see y'all motherfuckers later.